Hello, creators. Welcome back to our Effect House Crash Course for visual scripting. Are you ready to turn your TikTok effects from static to interactive without diving into complex coding? You're in the perfect place. Today, we're starting with the basics of interaction, the secret behind making your effects respond to user. What exactly is interaction? Picture flipping a light switch. The light turns on. That's an interaction in the physical world. Similarly, on your phone, tapping an icon to open an app is a digital interaction. In visual scripting, interactions allow your effects to react to users' actions, like a tap on the screen to trigger an animation, making an object change color when the camera detects a thumbs up. Interactions are crucial. They turn your effects into engaging experiences, encouraging users to play, experiment, and share. It's about turning viewers into participants. Three components of an interaction. There are three key components of an interaction: the trigger, the response, and the subject. Now, I'll show you how to set up a simple interaction where a sphere disappears after a screen tap. This will be broken down into four manageable steps. So first, ensure your visual scripting editor is open, right here. This is where we will build our interaction. Step one, select the object. So we'll need to add a 3D sphere here. You will see it show up in this preview panel, this panel right here, and this will be our subject. What you need to do is simply drag it over to the visual scripting editor and ready for scripting. Step two, setting up the trigger. Next, select the trigger that initiates the interaction in this example. We will make the sphere disappear with a screen tap. Right click, add notes, and we simply search screen tap. And this will become our trigger. Let's just delete all this noisy node stuff. So what will our screen tap do? Let's click on the info button here. It will execute the next node when the device screen is tapped. Cool. Step three, assigning responses. Now, let's decide what happens after the trigger, the response. We want the sphere to vanish upon tapping. So the node we're picking up here is the set visibility node. Its function is simply to show or hide an object by checking and unchecking the visibility on box. Straightforward, right? Let's connect those nodes. We want the screen tap. Remember in the last series, we said when the node is executed from left to right. So after the device detects the screen tap, the next step is set visibility, right? The visibility of which object the target should be linked to this object. What you want to do after the screen tap, you want to turn the visibility off, right? We need to leave this visibility off. Option unchecked. It's time to see your creation. Let's give this a try in the preview panel. Before you start, click on the restart button and simply just tap on the screen. See, the sphere disappeared. And if you want to try again, just simply click on the restart. The effect will reset and you can try again. It's simple, isn't it? Proper testing is vital to ensure your interaction functions as expected. Remember, no matter how complex the effect can be, it can boil down to the trigger, the response, and the subject. But the possibilities in Effect House are limitless. Every object, property, and asset can be a part of interaction. Let's say we want to simply just create maybe a material. We want to have a material called standard PBR. You can drag it over here and then manipulate it as a subject. So all these things are scriptable. Shortcut to add an interaction. We've covered the essentials of interactions. Now, let's make your workflow smoother. I'll introduce a shortcut for adding interactions using subgraphs, a set of pre-configured nodes designed for quick implementation. These subgraphs not only streamline the creation process, but also help organize your scripts by compartmentalizing different interaction elements. Now, imagine you want the sphere to appear when the user opens their mouth. We have that trigger in the library. you can actually detect when the user opens their mouth. Step 1. You still need to select the object sphere. And instead of keeping it visible, you need to make sure it's unchecked in the hierarchy panel, which basically makes it invisible before the user opens their mouth. Then, head over to the inspector panel and find the button called Add Interaction. Now remember, you don't need to drag the sphere into the visual scripting editor right now. After you click on Add Interaction, you will see there is a list of interactions you can select from. From the menu, we are going to pick the one called Show When Mouth Opens. Voila! Oh my gosh, this is so cool! You can see the object node automatically linked to its interaction graph. You don't need to do anything here. Just one click and the interaction's done. Let's give it a test on our preview panel. You can go to the preview menu here and select the one that can do mouth open. And you see, when the mouth opens, the sphere appears. Isn't that simple? The Add Interaction button is your gateway to effortlessly create complex interactions. If you're interested to learn in depth how to use this interaction library, go check out our Adding Interaction to a TikTok Effect tutorial in our channel. Now let's take a closer look at the anatomy of interaction subgraphs. Interaction subgraphs in EffectHouse are designed for full customization. Simply try double-clicking on a subgraph using Detect Face Movement to show/hide object. You'll discover two integral components. First is the Event Trigger subgraph. This outlines the specific conditions or user actions that initiate the effect. It consolidates all related nodes necessary for triggering the interaction. The second is the Event Response subgraph. This determines what happens after the trigger is activated, encompassing all nodes responsible for executing the subsequent actions. These components are the backbone of every interaction, allowing you to create complex and responsive effects with clarity and efficiency. Customizing interactions. Subgraphs are not just for organization. This is where the creativity really begins. I love to mix and match different trigger and response subgraphs to customize my own interactions. For example, you remember when we previewed it and the trigger only showed up once? Well, I want the visibility to be toggled as the mouth opens. So what can we do about it? Let's go back to the main subgraph. And first, we need to search a subgraph. An interaction that can do toggle visibility. We'll hand it over to the inspector panel. Click on the Add Interaction and simply just search toggle. So now we're gonna use this as our reference. You'll see a tap screen to toggle visibility is added to the canvas. Double click on it and we'll see. There is a response subgraph here called toggle visibility. This is the subgraph we are gonna bring in our new interaction. You can simply copy it from here and bring it over to another interaction. I'm going to use Command C because I'm on Mac, but if you're on Windows, use Control C and then click on the navigation main graph and it will jump you back to the first layer and go to your old interaction subgraph. Double click and paste this toggle visibility response here. You need to disconnect the old response from here and reconnect it to the new response. I'm going to link the beginning to this new subgraph. Don't forget to link the target to the new graph and start hidden. Just make sure all the links are properly set up before you delete this old response. Now that we just set up a new customized interaction to properly test, you need to delete this reference interaction subgraph. Make sure you delete it. It's important. Okay. Now for the test. Head over to the preview panel and click on this drop-down menu where you can select different videos to test on your effect. We're going to pick the one with someone's mouth actually opening. Okay, so we have options for opening the mouth here. When you see your mouth open, it will toggle the visibility on and off instead of just once. Pretty simple, right? You can try to mix and match any subgraphs you want. Don't limit your imagination. The key is to experiment with different combinations to discover what works best for your project and most resonates with your audience. EffectHouse has a vast library of triggers and responses that give you the freedom to be as innovative and diverse as your imagination flows. And you can also view more here in the asset library, where we have more subgraphs. You can download and import these into your effect project. Sneak peek to advanced customization. As you get comfortable with visual scripting and nodes, you can dive deeper into these subgraphs. Double click on the event trigger. This will open up the exact node that drives the trigger, and you can check out how this node works. Check out our website learning resources to learn more about it. We will sometimes provide an example to better show you how to use this node. If you go back, you can also double click on the event response subgraph. It will show you all the nodes that set up their functionality here, and you can configure your interaction at this very bottom level. For beginner users, you don't need to rush into customization on this layer, but you can use it as an opportunity to learn. Checking out every node functionality, understand its purpose, and you can also watch how nodes link together. It's perfect for you to understand how effects are actually constructed. You can try to copy and paste all these nodes into your own project. This hands-on approach is not just about mimicking. It's about learning and understanding the essence of visual scripting. Also, sometimes if you accidentally disconnect or delete any nodes, you will see immediately from the preview panel that this logic is broken. But you can always bring it back with Command-Z on Mac or Control-Z on Windows, and the effect will go back to normal. But remember, embracing a mistake is part of the journey. Each interaction, each subgraph, carries a potential for new innovative effects. This will serve as an arrow pointing you on your path to proficiency in EffectHouse and visual scripting. So remember to take your time and explore your own pace, as well as enjoy the journey into the world of visual scripting with EffectHouse. Conclusion. We've just begun to scratch the surface of interactive effects and subgraphs. Continue to explore, experiment, and engage with your creations. Your journey from novice to visual scripting pro is underway. Quiz time. Can you envision a real-life interaction, like flipping a switch, and translate it into a digital effect? Share your imaginative concepts below. Congratulations on taking significant strides in your visual scripting journey. Stay tuned, practice continually, and join us for more insights. Subscribe, like, and become part of our growing community. Until next time, keep creating, keep experimenting, and see you on the next tutorial. Stay tuned for our next module, where we'll dive into variables and data types, essential tools for advancing your visual scripting skills.